Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum, dear girls. How are you? Hope you are all fine. I'm Sadhu Fishwa from Army Burnhall College for Girls, Abbottabad. Today I am going to deliver last topic of chapter 11, that is electrostatics. Before moving further, let me come to the review of previous lecture 8. In the previous lecture, I taught you electric polarization, energy stored in a capacitor, and we discussed two salt examples. After listening to today's lecture, you would be able to understand the process of charging and discharging a capacitor. In case of charging and discharging a capacitor, we come to a circuit diagram. The circuit diagram, it consists of RC series circuit. This is R, the resistance. This is C, the capacitor. And you notice here, these are the two terminals, that is the switch. This is the battery. The battery provides V naught, that is the maximum EMF, the maximum energy, potential difference. So what happens? When one and two terminals are connected, when you switch on the circuit, what will happen? This is the positive of the battery, negative of the battery, positive plate of the capacitor, negative plate of the capacitor. Now the circuit is ready to work. This is the charging process. In case of charging process, what happens? The charges flow from the positive end of the battery towards the positive plate of the capacitor. All right? And the process of charging takes place. What happens? The negative charges move from positive towards negative plate and start to deposit at the positive, at the negative end of the plate. That is the plate of the capacitor. If we draw a graph, charge versus time, that is QT curve. And in case of charging process, we notice one thing, that this is the first curve which is coming up, that is given by RC. What is RC? R is a product of RC, which is a product of R, the resistance, and C, the capacitance. From where it comes, we notice one thing, that this RC is equal to time. What is time? Time is giving you that duration in which the capacitor is fully charged or discharged. This time factor is equal to RC. There is a derivation, we can prove it. From Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. From the definition of electric current, I is equal to Q by T. And from the equation of capacitor, Q is equal to CV. When we utilize all these three equations, we get RC, which is equal to T. So, in that case, we notice this is giving you large RC. This is giving you small RC. This is the case for charging process. In case of charging process, large RC means capacitor takes more time to be charged fully. The dotted line shows the maximum charges which are deposited or stored at the plates of a capacitor. All right, now we come to the discharging of a capacitor. We notice here that we have disconnected this portion. We have disconnected this switch. We are not using this source of battery, but we are using the stored energy which we stored in charging process. All right, and the charging process means now the charges are ready to flow in this direction using the energy in the form of charges. So in that case, when the discharging takes place, in that case, the first one, that is the charging, This is the small value of RC, large value of RC, starting from the origin. But in this graph, we notice that this graph is not started from the origin, because in case of discharging process, the maximum value of the charges are stored. We are going to utilize them. So the discharging process, the large RC, the small RC. In the charging process, the large RC, the small RC. The large RC means the capacitor takes more time to be charged. Small RC, the capacitor takes less time to be charged. Similarly, in case of discharging process, large RC means large time to be discharged gradually. Small RC means the capacitor takes small time to be discharged. All right. So you can see the process of charging and discharging of a capacitor in the light of these two circuit diagrams, RC series circuit and the two graphs. And here we notice one thing, that time factor is very important. We notice here that this gives you the maximum value of the charge, and 0.63 Q0 charges are deposited. And similarly, in case of discharging process, what happens? This is the discharging process, and in equilibrium, what we observe, that how much charges are discharged? 37 point Q. Okay, we are going to prove it. Charging and discharging a capacitor. Electronic flash guns for cameras have to be left for a short period of time between flashes. There is a capacitor inside that stores energy. It needs to be charged up again by the battery in the flash gun. The time taken for this depends on the rate at which the charge is flowing, which in turn is determined by the resistance of the circuit. It can take a couple of seconds before the capacitor is fully charged. Okay, let me first come to the charging process. Charging a capacitor, again we come to the circuit diagram, that is an RC series circuit as shown in the given figure. S is the switch. When switch S is closed, then it means we have connected the capacitor with the source of battery, providing V voltage to the circuit through the resistance R. The charge builds up gradually on the plates to the maximum value of Q0. As I told you earlier, that the process of charging, it takes place gradually. When you charge the capacitor, it will not charge simultaneously. Soon it will not charge fully. It takes some time, and that time is known as the time constant. And the time constant, it depends upon the product of R and C. The charge builds up gradually till it reaches the maximum value Q0. When we plot a graph, charge versus time, we notice that at t is equal to 0, when t is equal to 0, then there is no charge which is deposited. But with the passage of time, after some time t, when the charges start to flow, then what will happen? The current, it drops as the charge on the plates increases. So when the charges flow, passes through the resistance, then there is a potential drop. And finally, the charges start to deposit at the plates of the capacitor. Charging will stop when the potential difference between the capacitor plates is equal to the EMF of the battery. So the process of charging takes place till the potential difference which is developed across the plates of the capacitor is equal to the potential difference of the source. When this happens, the charging process completes. The maximum charge on the capacitor is equal to what? Capacitance into EMF of the battery. That is, Q is equal to C into V. experiment shows that the charging process of a capacitor exhibits the exponential behavior. Therefore, we can write its equation. So the exponential behavior is to be considered. And we are going to relate the two charges, Q, the instantaneous value of the charge. Q naught is giving you the maximum value of the charge and how these are related exponentially. So, girls, the proof of the equation is beyond the syllabus. That's why I'm not discussing it directly. In this derivation, we are going to use equation number one directly. Where in this equation number one, E, it has a fixed numerical value and it is given by 2.7182. Okay, so let me come to the graph again. So what happens with the passage of time? When the time starts to increase, Q increases until we come to the flat portion of the curve, and the flat portion of the curve means the maximum charge Q naught is deposited. All right, you can see here in the graph that shows relationship between charge and time, and we get here tau, two tau, four tau, and each of the curve is giving you the time constant. The time constant, do remember one thing, it could this is only the factor which is used to draw down the time taken to charge or discharge a capacitor completely. The bigger the capacitance, the longer it takes to charge the capacitor. So when I taught you previously the topic where you calculated the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, I told you that every capacitor has a capacity. For example, if we are having a beaker has the capacity to fill water only 4 liters, and if you fill it 3 liter water, it means it still has some capacity to be filled, right? But if you want to fill water beyond the limit, you are unable. Similarly, each of the capacitor has some capacity, and up to that capacity you can charge the capacitor, you can store the charge. The larger the resistance, the smaller the current. All right, which also increases the charging time. So the factor RC is called the time constant. How you calculate the time constant? The time constant is the duration of time for the capacitor in which 63.2% of its maximum charge is deposited on the plates. This is the time which is taken to charge the capacitor at its maximum value, only 63.2. So how to find it? By putting the value of time constant, as I told you, T is equal to RC. So the first equation, in the first equation, instead of T, we have to put this value. So what comes? Minus RC over RC, these two cancel. What comes? Q is equal to Q naught, 1 minus E power minus 1. So that would be Q naught 1 minus 1 over E. Putting the value of E over here, what comes? We write down this value. Q is equal to Q naught, this one. And finally, by rearranging, simplifying, converting it into percentage, what we get? 63.2%. So this gives you a comparison between the two charges. Q over Q naught is 63.2%. When 63% of the initial charge stored on the plates of the capacitor, then this determines time constant for the charging process. The graphs also shows that the charge reaches its maximum value sooner when the time constant is small. Smaller the value, reaches the value sooner. So greater the time, we reach the maximum value in more time. All right? The same is the case for the discharging process. But in case of discharging process, we notice one thing, that in case of discharging a capacitor, we are not going to use the source of battery. Why? Because the capacitor is now fully charged and we can utilize that stored energy. For this purpose, definitely you are going to make the connections so that S is closed. When S is closed, then what happens? The charges start to flow in this direction. In case of this case, the charges, the current start to flow in anticlockwise direction, and it passes through the resistance R and neutralize the charge minus Q on the left plate, vice versa. Assuming the fully charged capacitor begins the charging process at time t is equal to zero. Just in case of charging the capacitor, the charging time starts t is equal to zero. Similarly, in case of discharging process, the charge discharging time where it starts, t is equal to zero. This is giving you t is equal to zero. But at t is equal to zero, because the capacitor was fully charged, storing which charge? Q naught, which is equal to C into V naught. So what comes? We are going to use this equation for the discharging process. Q is equal to Q naught E minus T over RC. The same, we are going to put the value of the time constant. T is equal to RC. When we put here T is equal to RC, what comes? Q is equal to Q naught. Putting the value of E, using simplifying it, we come to this fraction, 0.367, converting into percentage. So in this way, we are comparing the two charges, Q and Q naught. What comes, how much it is discharged? 36.7%, the capacitor is discharged. And these curves are showing the discharging time. Discharging time, same. So less discharging time in small values and vice versa. Application that is uses of this process, that is charging and discharging. Capacitor discharge ignition CDI system is a type of automotive electronic ignition system which is widely used in motorcycles, lawn mowers, chainsaws, small engines, turbine powered aircraft, and some cars. And wipers. When the wipers of your car works, they work on the principle of charging and discharging the capacitor. It was originally developed to overcome the long charging times associated with high inductance coil. So in order to increase the charging times, we use inductive coils. Inductance means device which is used to store charge. We call that coil. That coil which stores energy is known as inductive coils. It is a solenoid basically, and it is more suitable for high engine speeds, for small engines, racing engines, and rotary piston engines. It can enhance the capability of power supply and make the spark much stronger. So beta, in the end, we come to a famous quotation of Albert Einstein. The world will not be destroyed by those who do evil, but by those who wash them without doing anything. Okay, beta, this is the end of the chapter.